In our fourth unit, that is measurement of energy, the contents are discussed: construction and working principle of induction type energy meter, errors of the induction type energy meter. Today we are revising that with this PPT and new topics 1 and 2 numerical based on this calibration of energy meter, or how to find error in the energy meter, that numericals we are going to discuss here. Yes, then upcoming discussion based on electronic energy meter and TOD meter. Okay, our course outcome to complete is we are able to explain construction, working principle and use of dynamometer type watt meter for measurement of power under balance and unbalanced condition. What is the working of energy meter? Last time we had started the discussion. The meter which is used for measuring the energy utilized by the electric load is known as the energy meter. The energy is the total power consumed and utilized by the load at a particular interval of time. It is used in the domestic and industrial AC circuit for measuring the power consumption. The meter is less expensive and accurate. Here, it is work on induction type principle. The energy meter has the aluminum disc whose rotation determines the power consumption of the load. You can see in this diagram also, here aluminum disc, and it is rotating due to the electromagnetic field generated due to the shunt magnet and series magnet. The disc is placed between the air gap of the series and shunt electromagnet. The shunt magnet has the pressure coil and the series magnet has the current coil. The pressure coil creates the magnetic field because of the supply voltage, and the current coil produces it because of the current. The field induced by the voltage coil is lagging by 90 degrees on the magnetic field of the current coil, because of which eddy current induced in the disc. The interaction of the eddy current and the magnetic field causes torque, which exerts a force on the disc. The disc starts rotating. The forces on the disc is proportional to the current and voltage of the coil. The permanent magnet controls their rotation. Permanent magnet opposes the movement of the disc, that is said here brake magnet, and it opposes due to the Lenz law, which equalizes it on the power consumption. The cyclometer counts the rotation of the disc. Here resistor mechanism is developed as a construction part, and it will count the number of rotations or number of impulse by this meter. There are four main systems: driving system, moving system, braking system and resistor systems in the induction type energy meter. Last time I have drawn this diagram on the board, also explained each and every part with its errors and remedies over on it. Please note that there are four main parts: shunt magnet, series magnet, pressure coil and current coil, aluminum disc, and overall spindle and its resistor mechanism, brake magnets, along with the bearings as shown in figure. You know that pressure coil is connected across to the supply, current coil is connected in series with the load or supply. That is also shown here. The driving system has electromagnets like shunt and series, and this aluminum disc which has the driving torque on it. You know that how it is generated, and it is proportional to the power generated. Driving torque is proportional to the power, and control torque generated by this brake magnet is proportional to number of rotation of the disc, as Lenz law, that number of rotation should stop with the help of this brake magnet. So that reason, in a controlling torque, or we can say control mechanism, the generated torque is proportional to number of revolutions. We can equate at steady state condition, driving torque is equal to controlling torque. So we are getting P is equal to N. Multiplying by T on both sides, you are getting energy is equal to integration of N dt. So that is nothing but number of revolution into time. So that is the expression of energy. Last time I have solved that on board. Then this moving system, you got it. What are the moving parts? Aluminium disc is the part which is rotating here. Due to induction effect, it is rotating. Now braking system is developed by this brake magnet. Lenz law is responsible to stop this disc. You can adjust the distance of brake magnet to the aluminium disc for minimizing or optimizing the speed of the aluminium disc. Then there is a resistor mechanism. It is placed near the jewel bearings or near the top of this induction type energy meter. It start to count while rotating of this aluminium disc. I have also shared one video with you. That video explains the fundamental of the energy meter, what are the types of energy meter and related diagram and overall. So it will help for your enhancing understanding about the prerequisite of this energy meter. Also my lecture helps to understand this. Now this is new topic for you. There is a numerical based on this energy meter. Up till this, any doubt please discuss.